My name is Jeff Bush. We're at UCSF, this is where my lab works on trying to understand how birth defects occur. And we try to understand at the cellular level what the cell signaling events are that coordinate development, and then how that goes wrong in birth defects. We particularly focus on birth defects of the face, so congenital anomalies that influence the face, so like cleft lip and cleft palate or craniosynostosis. So cleft lip and cleft palate. Cleft lip is basically a hole in the front of the face or in the roof of the mouth. I would love to discover something that would be informative or instructive in terms of therapeutic for a birth defect. I spend about half of my time, I would say, writing. And that's writing papers and grants and emails that are related to science. And then I spend the other, maybe 40% of my time actually in the lab in some way, and that can either be actually doing experiments myself or helping other people do experiments, working together with other people in the lab. And then maybe, 10 or 15% of my time doing other things like meetings and administrative responsibilities. I was born in Lowell, Massachusetts, but I grew up in Western New York in a town called Palmyra, which is a pretty small town in Western New York. I've always been interested in science, generally, and I would say that one sort of formative experience is that my brother has a developmental disability called Rubenstein-Tabes syndrome. So that was sort of a formative experience. And then really got interested in developmental biology as a science in college. So in college I worked in a developmental biology lab. I thought it was great. Yeah, I'm passionate about discovery. So the thing that excites me is going in and learning something new that maybe nobody's ever seen before, that tells me something about really how we're built as humans. Actually, I think there's a pretty broad set of skills that all can be very useful in science. And so there are scientists that are extremely different personality-wise. People have different strengths, and actually that works out well when you have a team of people that all have different strengths. I do think that in order for it to be fun, you have to be interested in the discovery. You have to care what the underlying question is.
Definitely.
Woo!
Okay. So let's try that one.
Okay.
It's really very exciting to make a discovery that, really that nobody has ever made before. So that is what drives me, and that's what the reason that I think most people do this. But there are variations on that. So some people are really passionate about discovering something biomedically related. They want to help people, they want to cure diseases. And that's sort of in there for me, but I also, my real passion is trying to fundamentally understand what's happening.